Hey, what's up guys, welcome back. You are watching for today. From few days we reviewed lots of custom ROMs and the custom JS build, which gives you the true pixel experience for any Android device out there in the market. But today we got something more refined, which has AOSP base of Lineage OS 22.2 called as Axion OS. This is a pure Android experience for your aged old device with the addition of some useful features. Axion OS is optimized to run seamlessly on older Android devices and helping you to extend their lifespan. It also helps to save money on upgrading your device while contributing to the greener planet by reducing e-waste. While reviewing this ROM, I got some new features which I didn't found till the date in any of custom ROMs or JS builds. I flashed its unofficial custom ROM build on my Nothing Phone 1 and custom JS build on OnePlus 9RT. So don't worry, if your device is not in the list, you can use Axion OS custom JS on any Android device running with the ARM64AB dynamic system with unlocked bootloader. Today in this video, we'll review all the new unique and useful features of Axion OS, its user interface, and at the last, I've shown some bugs if you are thinking to try its JS build on your device. Now without further delay, let's get started. I am using the Axion OS custom JS build using DS loader on the OnePlus 9RT and custom ROM on Nothing Phone 1. But in video, I will review this build only on my 9RT device. Everything will remain same for custom GSI and custom ROM, except the bugs that you will find in the bug section of this video. First, we will check about device details of this build. This is the Axion OS 1.3 version. This is Android 15 based ROM. As this is the Lineage OS 22.2 source based ROM, you will get its Easter egg if you tap repeatedly on Axion OS version. ROM comes with the latest security patches of April 2025. Kernel version of this GSI will remain same like your stock ROM, while custom ROM kernel version may differ as per the device you are using. Build date of this ROM is of latest 1st May 2025. So whatever older device you are using, custom ROM world will provide you the latest security patches and the latest source base through such amazing ROMs. Let's first check out the useful and unique features which I didn't found and working in most of the ROMs. The ROM comes with the Pulse launcher, which is a custom launcher of this OS, still Google's new Android 15 private space feature is working in this. You can set up the Google private space, which is available in the security and the privacy option of the setting, and this feature will work great. Till the date, I didn't seen other custom ROMs which have their own launcher except the Pixel launcher. None of was able to make it work this feature in their custom launcher. Next are some lock screen features. First one is a weather information on the lock screen. This is just not a weather info. You will get the detailed info about the wind speed and humidity percentage of your current location on the lock screen. You can customize the weather icons with bunch of different options available. Next are the interactive lock screen widgets. You can add multiple lock screen widgets like Wi-Fi, Wi-Fi hotspot, Bluetooth, data network, etc. and can control them directly on the lock screen without unlocking your device. Weather and lock screen widget features are available in most of highly customizable ROMs, but they are not available in any of AOSP ROM, which are most essential feature and added by the Axion OS, excluding other useless customizations of lock screen. One of the most interesting thing I noticed that in the location setting, there is one toggle named as assisted GPS. This feature will download the satellite assisted data from internet, which will greatly improve the GPS startup performance and the accuracy of the GPS in the maps applications. Next, in the display setting, we get another new option called as HDR display. This will enable the peak brightness for HDR content played on your device via YouTube or by any media player. I tested this feature by playing HDR video on YouTube with this feature enabled, and I found some improvement in the quality of videos. Next, in same display setting, we get the smart cover option, which will be helpful for users which are using smart covers for their devices. By using this feature, you can set the activity of smart cover on the lock and sleep mode. In the navigation mode setting, we can enable or disable the circle to search, and it's working good. Even we get the smart taskbar, which will give you the access of home screen dock applications and app drawer by swiping up on the navbar. We can open any smart bar application as a split screen by dragging them in a currently running application. Or we can access the app shortcuts by long pressing on the smart bar application icons. This feature is already available in the lots of highly customizable ROM, but in this ROM it's working very fluid. Next, at the bottom of the setting panel, in the special feature option, we get lots of miscellaneous features. One of that is a game space. This is already available in lots of ROMs, but in this ROM, it offers force unlock higher FPS, which should work for most of devices. Instead of this, in the battery setting, we get the balance and performance mode setting. I didn't show this option in video, but you can check that in mentioned setting. Performance mode will help you to play the games with the maximum fluidity in this ROM. In the spoofing setting, we get the play integrity fix option if you face any kind of issue with the play integrity checks. Netflix spoofing is actually working in the Axion OS. It's enabled by default in the ROM. If you check the DRM info of your device, it will show you the security level as L1. So you can stream Netflix and the Amazon Prime with the full HD resolution. Even in a developer setting, bootloader unlocker state is got spoofed as lock condition, so you can use all the banking or security application without issues in this build. Next is a true multitasking using multi-window setting. This feature is available for lots of highly customizable ROM, but it's not available in the AOSP ROMs, but AxionOS added this useful feature in their ROM, so you can use app sidebar and can do true multitasking. In the system and gesture setting, for double press power button, you can assign multiple shortcuts or applications, so you can double press power button for more productive activities. This function is not available in most of the custom ROM and GSR build. So we've seen some of the unique and essential customization features which added by this AOSP based ROM. It will help you to increase the productivity of your device. User interface of this ROM is another great part, which offers unique look for volume slider, QS panel, app drawer, recents panel, settings panel, which resembles with the Pixel user interface and offers all working widgets of Pixel devices. By using Monet theming, you can customize the look of colors and can convert the Monet themes into the next level user interface of your device. Today, I will not discuss working features of this ROM. We will only discuss what are issues of the GSI build and the custom ROM that I tested for Nothing Phone 1. In custom GSI build of AxionOS on my 9RT, OnePlus alert slider is not working. Fingerprint unlock is not available in the setting, but you can use face unlock option. LTE and 5G networks are working with the data, but whenever we make calls, it will switches on the 2G calling. Except that there are no issues of the GSI build. For Nothing Phone 1, everything is working. For AxionOS, only grip flashlight is not working for Nothing camera application. So basically, this ROM on the Nothing Phone 1 and custom GSI build for any device can be considered as a daily drivable build. This is all about for today, guys. Hope you liked our work. Then please do like and share this video. Subscribe to our channel. Press the bell icon to get such amazing content to save life of your old device and ecosystem of our earth by extending the uses of your smartphones. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Take care. Bye bye.